किसकी की कल्प वृक्ष प्राप्ति हो
मन गेट्स अ डिजायर्ड फुलफिलिंग ट्री स्वर्ग लोक
कल्प स्वर्ग संपत प्राप्ति हो जाए
स्वर्ग संपत ओए तीर्थपाद माइक वेयर इज द माइक
गुरु प्रीति
पुट इट बैक
गुरुदेव जी भी प्रसन्न हो
गुरुदेव इज हैप्पी प्लीज विद यू वैकुंठ युगिनापि दुर्लभम
गुरुदेव की कृपा होने पर
इफ यू हैव मर्सी ऑफ गुरु
होने पर
देन
योगियों की यह अत्यंत दुर्लभ वस्तु
इवन फॉर योगीज इट इज वेरी वेरी हार्ड टू अटेन दिस
भगवत धाम प्राप्त हो
वैकुंठ भगवत धाम में
वृंदावन बिहारी लाल
इफ यू हैव द मर्सी ऑफ गुरुदेव
ये शास्त्र में जितने भी बात कही गई
एवरीथिंग दैट्स बीन सेड इन द स्क्रिप्चर्स
सभी के एक तात्पर्य है
द एसेंस ऑफ एवरीथिंग इज दिस
गुरुदेव के प्रति
टू फॉर गुरुदेव हाउ कैन वी डेवलप फर्म फेथ टुवर्ड्स हिम
गुरु ही कृपा गुरु कृपा ही
गुरु कृपा ही केवलम
ध्यान मूलम गुरु मूर्ति
ध्यानमूलम गुरु मूर्ति सोर्स ऑफ ऑल काइंड ऑफ इंकर्नेशन इज इमिटेशन इज दिस मंत्र मूलम गुरु वाक्य
मोक्ष
मूलम गुरु कृपा
ध्यान मूलम गुरु मूर्ति
ध्यान मूलम गुरु मूर्ति
कितने प्रकार के ध्यान कहा
ऑल काइंड ऑफ मेडिटेशन अमंग ऑल ऑफ देम
गुरुदेव की ध्यान मूर्ति का ध्यान गुरुदेव की मूर्ति
We should meditate upon Guru's form, Guru Murti, Puja Mulam Guru Padam. All the worships that we do, the essence of everything is worshipping the lotus feet of Sri Guru. We must worship the lotus feet of Sri Guru. Mantra Mulam Guru Vakyam, all the mantras, all the mantras that we chant. There is only one motive of all the mantras. How to get mercy of Sri Guru. Mantra Mulam Guru Vakya. Whatever Guru is speaking, their mantras. How to follow instructions of Sri Guru. This we should always think. Moksha Mulam Guru Kripa. There is only one way to obtain liberation. That is only possible through mercy of Guru. By mukti, we mean prema bhakti. You can only get prema bhakti by the mercy of Guru. In this shloka, the context is this. Mukti has many, many contexts. This is the main one. To be free from sadness and stress, this is also mukti, liberation.
Vishnu Angri
Labhangi Mukti. Attaining the lotus feet of God also is called Mukti. The best topmost definition of Mukti is what it is. What is it? Realizing the own transcendental spiritual form and then serving the Prabhu, the worshipable. This is the topmost definition of Mukti. This is Bhakti. Many definitions of Mukti. But yet, the topmost Mukti is what it is. Realizing your own transcendental spiritual form. When listen Hari Katha slowly and slowly. Sinnatang sakata Krishna. If you don't listen Krishna katha, listen Krishna katha, this is Krishna entering your ears and sitting in your heart. You are listening to Hari Katha. Hari Krishna himself. Shabda Brahma. Hari Katha, listening to Hari Katha means Shabda Brahma. Srinatang sakata Krishna. Srinatang sakata Krishna. Punya kirtana.
Chabatrani bidinti sweet sthana. Hidai mein jitne bhi mail jo hai.
All kind of dirt in the heart. Anger, lust.
Laabh, puja, pratishtha. Jitne prakar ki unwanted things.
All kind of unwanted things.
Nikal de. Asthain Bhagawan hidai mein. Mitra ke bhaanti.
And God, he sits in the heart. And then the heart is purified. That's why Hari Katha Shravan.
Changing.
That's why Swarnakadi Rishis
जो पांच प्रश्न
क्वेश्चंस
ये छह प्रश्न ही
सिक्स क्वेश्चंस
श्रीमद् भागवत ही कहा
गया श्रीमद् भागवतम
18,000 श्लोक की जितने भी
18,000 श्लोकस
स्थान ये छह प्रश्न के उत्तर उसमें ही विराजमान है
द आंसर इज देयर
देखो संसोनकादि ऋषि लोग
सोनकादि ऋषि
सुत गोस्वामी पाद यह प्रश्न पूछा
सुत गोस्वामी पाद आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन
पहली प्रश्न पूछा
द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज
पुरुषों के जो है एकांत श्रेय क्या है
व्हाट इज द टॉप मोस्ट गोल ऑफ द जीवास
वो मुझे बताएं मनुष्य की श्रेय क्या है
व्हाट इज द टॉप मोस्ट थिंग दैट ह्यूमंस कैन गेट
श्रेय वस्तु और एक है श्रेय वस्तु
चेंज द माइक
इस संसार में
इन दिस वर्ल्ड
प्रिय वस्तु जो मुझे अच्छी जो मेरा प्रशंसा करते हैं अच्छी लगती है इसलिए प्रिय
व्हाट इज द सुप्रीम वेलफेयर
माता पिता भाई बंधु स्त्री पुत्र परिवार
We like this love given by mother, parents. But what is it? In Kali Yuga, there is no other process. The benefit is only in this thing. If you listen Harikatha, then it is the topmost benefit. Listening Bhagavad Katha from Sadhu.
Avashrava mukhod girnam Buddha harikatham mutam Sravanam naiva kartabham Sapachishtam jagmukham Vaishnava ke mukharabind se
If you listen from Vaishnavas, if you listen Harikatha, this is being recommended in scriptures. If you listen from a non-Vaishnava, then the heart is contaminated if you listen Harikatha from a non-Vaishnava. Like if you drink milk, the body becomes healthy. But look that milk. If it is contaminated by the touch of a snake, then the milk is becomes poisonous.
और वह दूध में यदि लग जाए और जान में अनजान में
knowingly or unknowingly if you drink that poison milk you will die
इसे कहा जाता है अवश्य
और दिस रिगार्ड अ वैष्णव मुक्त ग्रीनम तो हरि कथा अमृतम
श्रवणम नहीं सर्वोच्चिष्ट जगत वैष्णव के मुखार में से
Listen Harikatha from Vaishnavas, from Shuddha Vaishnavas. From them listen Harikatha. That's why, how the Jivas can get delivered. Listen Harikatha from Vaishnavas. The question will come, who is a Vaishnava? One who has received initiation by the Vishnu Mantra is a Vaishnava. Those who worship Vishnu are also called Vaishnava. Those who worship Shakti is called Sakta. Those who worship Shiva are called Shaivas. Those who worship Sun, Surya, they are called Sorja. Those who worship Ganapatya. And those who worship Vishnu are called Vaishnava. Vaishnava and Priyam. Srimad Bhagavatam is very very beloved of Vaishnavas. Explanation is coming. Forgive me, but this is truth. What's in scriptures? Vaishnavas, they like this scripture so much. Shivji himself even. He is the topmost Vaishnava.
Yathasham.
Among all the Vaishnavas, the topmost Vaishnava is Shivji Maharaj. Shivji himself, he explained this katha to his wife Devi Parvati in Amarnath, in the cave of Amarnath. Bhagavat katha, they explained. This is called Amar katha, the immortal katha also. Very beautiful this is, no? We need time to explain all the topics, but so anyways I'll take this. Once upon a time,
Devi Parvati
was sitting, and Devadide Mahadev, he went outside for do some work. Meantime Narad Rishi came.
Narad Rishi
going everywhere. So for he entered, after seeing him, Devi Parvati became very happy, and he offered a seat. She offered a seat to Narad Rishi. Then Narad Rishi, wherever he goes, he is like causing prema arguments, meaning he is increasing prema actually. He said, see how your husband is. Devi said, my husband is unique and unparalleled, he's very nice. In his mouth, sometimes he's always he's speaking Krishna Katha, Ram Katha, nothing else he speaks. Lord Shiva always absorbed in the Katha of Ram and Krishna. Look, Devi. She started to glorify her husband, and Narad Rishi was listening. After some time, Narad Rishi said, your husband is very nice.
He's nice.
Whatever you should not speak, your husband, my husband, tell me. See, what should you not tell? What should you keep confidential between husband and wife? Guru Mantra should be kept confidential between husband and wife. In scripture, it is explained. All mantras husband and wife can discuss, but Guru Mantra you never speak. But my husband Shivji, Parvati is saying, sometimes he is so much absorbed in his transcendental moods that he even tells everything. He tells me even confidential things he tells me. Narada Rishi became very happy, said, wow, very nice. He's very nice. Does anyone have a husband like this? I have a very nice husband, Parvati is saying. He's unique and unparalleled. He's very, very simple. When he's absorbed in his mood, he forgets everything. He's very simple and soft hearted. Whatever is not meant to be spoken, even he speaks. He said, Bhole Baba.
Bhole Baba.
Very beautiful name, yes, Bhole Baba. One who is very simple. Narad Rishi said, Devi, Parvati, tell me, in the throat of your neck, why is he wearing a bone garland made of skulls, bones? Why did he put ashes on his body? Why is he wearing snake in his neck? Why? Parvati said, he's renunciated. So that's why, Vairagi Baba. He's renunciated Baba. That's why he's putting, no problem, what's the big deal about it? Narad Rishi said, no. Devi, you don't know, you must know. Ved, Quran, Upanishad, all the scriptures, essence is there in this confidential secret. This ashes that he put is not ordinary. So outside we are saying, oh, he's renunciated. Renunciation, but no. This is Ved, Puran, Upanishad. Has Shivji tell you everything about this? Then Narad Rishi said, he has not told you anything. Then Devi Parvati, she became angry. That my husband hid something from me. Narad Rishi said, okay, you know, your husband know, I'm Santa Mahatma. Why will I come in middle of you two? After saying this, Narad Rishi went away from there. Then when he's going, he saw Shivji is coming. Shivji said, where are you coming from? Narad Rishi said, I'm coming from your house. Shivji thought, oh my god, today big problem. If Narad Rishi is coming from my house, I will not get food today. I will get fight today. Today I have to keep a fast. No food will be good for me today because Narad Rishi coming from my house. Because wherever Narad Rishi go in the house and he causes like trouble there, like an argument of love or something like this. So Shivji became afraid and he entered his house. I have this doorstep when he put his feet inside, Devi Parvati started to cry. Oh, you like this? You said, Devi, I never hide anything from you. I tell you everything, but you did not tell me this. Shivji said, oh, listen, wait. Have some patience. Why are you becoming angry? Narad Rishi came, yes, he came. Okay, I will tell you, listen. Shivji, he pacified his wife. And said, okay, sit down, I'll tell you. Then Devi said, why do you push ashes on your body? Why do you bear a garland of bones? The skulls. Shivji said, no, look. I'll tell you.
Devi,
depending age and time, we give up the body. Different age and time, we give up the body. In your separation, your each life's bone I collect and I put in this garland. I put in this garland, each bone from your different lifetime. The ashes are also connected to you. That's why I'm putting these ashes on my body. Life after life, you become my wife. So the ashes that you leave after your body is cremated, those ashes I'm putting on my body. In this material world, the marriage that happened, how many circles, rounds you take of the fire? Seven. Why seven? For seven lives, we will stay husband and wife. This is why seven, right? This is it. Very nice. Seven lives, stay husband wife together. Wow. If husband is rude, he speaks very rudely, harsh words. For seven lives, you want harsh speaking husband? Tell me. You want husband like this? You tell me, who wants husband like this? Pick up your hand. And if a wife is very harsh speaking, very rude, very loves to fight, create trouble, would you want a wife like this for more six lives, like seven lives? Once upon a time someone asked me this question. Maharaj, tell me, we're taking seven rounds of this fire sacrifice. For seven lives will be husband and wife. Okay, tell me, how do we identify which one is the first and which is the seventh? Are we being husband and wife for the first time or are we being husband and wife for the seventh time? More than seven life, right? So which one is it? The first one or the seventh one? This you tell me. This is the first or the last one? Tell me. I said, very simple answer. I said, if the first life, then the husband and wife, they are after marriage, they are living like pigeons, birds. You understand? Like love birds. Like pigeons loving. Have you seen pigeons? No? Have you seen? You can see on the top of electrical wires. Morning, you can see two on morning. They are kissing and sitting there. If one pigeon flies, the other also flies and follows it. Just like their beaks are always intertwined. Always. All their beaks are always intertwined, connected. If the husband and wife are like this, living like prema, like lovebirds, then think this is the first one. First time their husband and wife. And if husband and wife after marriage, like if you reverse the number 6, it becomes 9. In the same way, everything is turned upside down. And if it's like opposite, people are, the husband and wife are always fighting, then it's the 7th one. understanding my point. I'm saying this because
Narad Shivji
and like Shivji said, listen, Shiv and Parvati, no doubt in this thing that they always stay together. When the body ends of Parvati, in Bhagavat it is mentioned. Have you ever heard that Shivji left his body? Never. Shivji's one name is? What's the name? Amar, one who is immortal. Does not then cannot die. What's the mantra? Mahamrityunjay mantra. God's one name is Mrityunjay, one who wins over death. One who can even give you victory over death, like Mrityunjay. One who has won over the death. Devi Parvati said, Nath Pati Dev, who my husband. You're Mrityunjay, you have won over death. You have a victory over death. And I die? Can have I not won over death? Shivji said no. Parvati said, oh my dear husband, tell me please, how can I win over death? He said, look, to win over death there is one solution. Just listen the katha that makes you immortal. Amar katha. If you listen to that, you become immortal. Devi said, which Amar Katha? Which Katha is like makes you immortal? Have you eaten a fruit that makes you immortal? Amar Phal? You eat many, many fruits. Apple, you pass, banana. You eat banana or not? Today, what do you eat? You're saying you are eating fruits. Very nice, you are eating fruits. How many fruits are you eating? How many of you eat fruits? Pick up your hands. Who likes to eat fruit? Which fruit did you eat? Banana, guava, apple. And what else? Mango. Have you eaten a fruit, Amar Phal, like fruit that makes you immortal? Who have eaten it? Who has eaten it? You all have eaten it. Good listening, Katha, no? Just right now you're eating a fruit that makes you immortal. See, Shivji said, I have eaten this fruit that makes him mortal. Amar Phal. Devi Parvati said, give this food to me also, na? Amar Katha is Amar Phal. Clap. Gopi Gita is coming. राधा जी हिमसेल्फ, राधा जी इज गिविंग दिस एविडेंस. गोपी गीत इज सिंग सॉन्ग इन मेनी मेनी मेलोडीज. वेरी ब्यूटिफुल दिस गोपी गीत इज. Saying herself, Tato Kathamritam, your Katha is like Amrit, it's pure nectar. One who drinks this nectar, they become immortal, they don't die. Bhagavat Kathamritam, Sri Mad Bhagavat Kathamritam. श्रीमद भागवत कथामृतम. श्री मीन श्रीमती राधिका. आई गिव यू से सम पीपल आस्क देयर इज नो नेम ऑफ श्रीमती राधिका इन भागवत. ओके ओके वट एवर यू से ओके आई गिव प्रणाम स्वीट नो प्रॉब्लम. आचार्य से एवरीवेयर इज द नेम ऑफ श्री राधा. नथिंग नथिंग एल्स इज देयर अपार्ट फ्रॉम श्री राधा. I'm sorry. It's true. It's in scriptures. Shri Mad Bhagavat. Shri means Sarva Lakshmi Shri Mati Radhika. Without Radha, Krishna is half. Incomplete. Come in Vraj. Let's go to Vraj. Without Radha, Krishna is incomplete. That's why in Vraj nobody says Krishna, Krishna. What do they say? राधे. स्पीक लाउडली.
हेलो राधा रानी की
जय हो.
जय जय
राधा जी. शक्ति है
राधा जी इज द पोटेंसी पावर.
राम को ही बोलते हैं. क्या बोलते हैं? बोलो श्यावर रामचंद्र की
जय हो.
सीताराम राइट. और भी से राम सीता. द नेम ऑफ सीता कमिंग फर्स्ट और राम कमिंग फर्स्ट. सीताराम सिया रामचंद्र की जय. सिया द नेम ऑफ सीता इज कमिंग फर्स्ट. राधा रानी इन राम लीला मैनिफेस्टेड फॉर्म ऑफ सीता. सीता इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ श्रीमती राधिका. जुगलजोड़ी सरकार द कंजुगल डिवाइन कपल. इन ब्रज इफ यू गो एवरीबॉडी से दिस. वेरी नाइस.
मैं ये संकेत दे रहा हूँ आगे जाकर के बताऊँ. प्रमाण देकर राधा जी छोड़कर के नहीं कृष्ण
कोई विदाउट कृष्ण विदाउट श्रीमती राधिका कृष्ण हैज नो वैल्यू.
हमारे आचार्य से बात करते सर्वत्र राधा.
आचार्य दे एक्सप्लेन एवरीवेयर इज द नेम ऑफ श्रीमती राधिका.
प्रमाण बहुत है शास्त्र.
देयर आर मेनी एविडेंस इन द
स्क्रिप्चर. समझने वाले समझते हैं.
दोज हु हैव ब्रेन्स कैन अंडरस्टैंड. दोज हु हैव नॉलेज दोज हु सीक लॉजिक. बाय नॉलेज यू कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड. By logic and doubts, you cannot understand. If we have mercy of God, then we can understand. Those who don't understand, what can I do? Many people ask. Okay, anyways, let's listen katha. So Amar katha. Bhagavat katha is Amar katha.
Devi Parvati bole.
Devi Parvati said, Pati Dev.
मुझे भी अमृत अमर कथा को श्रवण
करें. I want Amar katha. Which katha?
कौन सा कथा श्रवण करें?
You are listening what? Speak loudly, na? Amar Katha. Give a big round of applause. This Katha will make you immortal. You did not clap loud enough. Clap loud. This is true.
Devi Parvati
said, explain Amar Katha to me. Devi said, listen. If I don't speak in front of unqualified, those who are unqualified. If you have desire to listen, but because the desire to listen must be there. First I explain. In this sloka it is coming. Shushrushwa. This is the desire of listening. It's called Shushrushwa. One who have the desire, then very nice. People of material world, they go here and there. They want to go for entertainment. But those who come to listen katha, Bhagavat katha, they are extremely fortunate. They are the most fortunate in this existence. to the demigods to listen, they are hankering. Before I explain, when Sukadeva Goswami Maharaj was just about to start speaking Bhagavatam Parikshit Maharaj, at that time all the devatas, demigods, Indra, they came with Amrit Kalash, with they came. See, even they are craving to listen this. Bhagavat Katha is not ordinary. Especially taking birth in this Bharat, India, not ordinary. Those who listen Bhagavat Katha, it's because you have done austerities for many lifetimes. You have done renunciation, austerities, then nothing is left. They've done many things. This is the last life. This is your last life. No need to take more life, more birth. Because you're listening this Katha, that make you immortal. No? That's why you won't die. It take you to abode of God. That's why Shivji is saying, I don't speak this to unqualified. Why? Because if they hear, they will make jokes, then offense will come. People will commit offense, right? That's why I don't speak carefully. Siddhi Parvati said, okay, tell me. Shivji said, okay, I will tell you. Because you have the desire, I will tell you. But in the middle, you must say and give me acceptance that you are listening. Say, then I will think you are listening. Sometimes while listening, we sleep, right? We fall asleep. Wherever Tattva Siddhant is there, then when Tattva Siddhant Katha come, then sleeping. When the dance is going on, Kirtan going, everyone is awake. But when Katha starts, Katha gives headache. Very hard to understand and process it in the brain. And especially this Bhagavat Katha, Amrit Katha. When Vyasadeva made Ganesh ji to write this, Ganesh ji said, when you stop, then I will stop. When you stop speaking, then I will stop. Vyasadeva said, okay, for once your head was cut and you were put on the head of an elephant. I tell you, listen carefully. He was right in a way. Whatever I say, you understand in your brain and then you write it. And if you don't understand and write, then your head will be cut again. That's when Bhagavat, there's a sloka, there's called Vyaskut. You need to understand this thing. This is your Vyaskut. In this shloka there are many meanings. You need to analyze it deeply and then write. Sanskrit is a language. One word has many meanings. Not one meaning a word has. The same word has many meanings. But which you have to understand the whole context and then you give the meaning of the word. So Ganesh started to write. And then when Vyasadeva spoke like this, then Ganesh was thinking. In the meantime, Vyasadeva, he spoke thousands of shlokas. That's why Vyaskut is coming. Okay, anyways. Katha is, it's very, very hard for everyone to understand Katha. The biggest and biggest of scholars, Sarvam Bhattacharya, Mulantvit. Atma Rama Shlok is coming here. 9 type of meanings he explained. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in front of him, he explained 18 type of meanings. 18 different. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that same shloka, he spoke to Sanatan Goswami and he explained the same shloka in 64 different ways. One shloka sees 64 explanations. That's why
सेन शिव जी कहने लगे,
शिव जी सेड लिसन,
कहीं कथा सुनते थे कहीं सो जाओ,
यू स्लीप व्हाइल
अनाधिकारी व्यक्ति
एंड अनक्वालिफाइड पर्सन लिसन, दे माइट लिसन इफ यू शैल लिसन, सो इन द मिडिल यू हैव टू से यू हैव टू गिव एक्सेप्टेंस दैट यू से एवरीबॉडी
क्या बोले
शिवजी स्टार्ट टू से देवी पार्वती इधर
देखो
लोग
बोलते प्रथम संत से लेके द्वितीय तृतीय
तो फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड फोर्थ फिफ्थ कैंटो किंग
और कार्तिक षष्ठ सप्तम अष्टम
सिक्स्थ कैंटो सेवंथ कैंटो
बहुत कठिन है खगोल भूगोल की
कथा द फर्दर कैंटो इज वेरी वेरी हार्ड टू अंडरस्टैंड Further, there are astrological explanation also in Bhagavatam.
और वह पर
देवी पार्वती slept.
और शिव जी तो बाप प्रेम से आंख बंद करके.
And Shivji absorbed in his mood. He was saying, "Prema was absorbed in his mood."
Shivji
was saying, "Pad." He started to explain his life. That Radha ji gave my instruction. She gave me instruction. Shuka, parrot, go to earth and spread the glories of this Braj there. And then the parrot of Srimati Radhika, Shuk. He manifested in form of an egg in the very very cold region, Amarnath. Amarnath and Shuka Pakshi manifested form of an egg. Very very cold it was. That time the mother of the bird, she went to find some food. It's all the desire of God. Same place where Shivji was explaining Amar Katha to Devi. In the meantime, a wind blew and the egg fell down.
It
fell down right at the place. The branch of a tree, it cracked open. The Shuka parrot came out from that. The Katha is so powerful. Shivji was speaking this transcendental vibration. After hearing this, the Shuka Pakshi's heart became like the bird became alive. The bird egg became alive after being even after being cracked immaturely. So it's so surprising. Devi Parvati is saying, The parrot started to replicate that sound, saying, in the voice of Parvati. Devi Parvati fell asleep. And the Shuka Pakshi parrot saying, Katha ended. In the meantime, if you open his eyes and saw, Devi Parvati was snoring.
Devi.
Oh yes, what happened? She woke up. Oh, I fell asleep a little bit. I was feeling dizzy. So who heard this Hari? Who was saying Shivji saw. This is very very like low temperature region, no one is here. On the tree, he saw parrot bird. The bird has heard the Amar Katha. Unqualified bird heard this. Shivji picked up his trident and started to run towards that bird. And he entered Vardhaka Ashram where Vyasadev with his wife Vitika was speaking this Katha, Puran Katha. And he was listening. Wife was listening. The mouth was open of Vyasadeva's wife. And he entered the mouth and he entered the womb of that. Her womb. Shivji came with the trident and asked Vyasadeva, have you seen this bird? Vyasadeva said, Mahadev, since when did you start hunting birds? Shivji said, no, this bird has heard Amar Katha, that's why I want to kill this bird. Vyasadeva said, if someone listens to this, they become immortal, right? Is it true? Shivji said, yes. One who listens to Amar Katha, they become Amar, immortal. One who has listened to Amar Katha, they became Amar, right? They are immortal already. So how can you kill? If you have heard Amar Katha, then how can you kill him? Then after hearing that, Shivji started to think, this is true. In the same way, Sukadeva was explaining his own life history. In the mother's womb, he stayed for 16 years. Some scriptures say 13, some say 16. 13, some say 16. Different age and time have different Harikatha. Anyways, in mother's womb stayed for 16 years. It's the womb started to pain. Mother was feeling pain. Vyasadeva said, who are you? Why are you sitting in the mother's womb? Come out. He said, I'm Sukha. Come out. Because mother is also feeling pain. We are staying inside. You also feeling pain. Come out. If I come out, Maya will catch me. That's why the Sukha said. Vyasadeva said, look, I, incarnation of Narada, I promise you, just you come out, Maya will not catch you. He said, I don't trust you. If Krishna appears here and promise me, then I will come out. Then Vyasadeva, he summoned Krishna, he called Krishna, and Krishna appeared and said, Shoka, come out from mother's womb, as soon as possible. See, on a thorn of a cow, if you throw a mustard seed on it, for the time that this mustard seed can stay on that thorn, in that time you have to come out, meaning come quickly.
Horn
of a cow. It's very, very hard. So Gita, God is saying, Devi Gesha Gunamai Maya. It's very, very hard to bring over Maya. Maya is very powerful. Devi Maya is like this. To win over it, it's not easy. By knowledge, renunciation, this you cannot attain. You cannot understand. Bhagavatam, many evidence are given. In the shlokas it is explained, it's not easy to win over Maya. In Gita, God is saying, you just need to surrender to God to win over it. And then God appeared and he said, I will put Maya away, Maya will not touch you. When he said this, the Sukha, he came out from mother's womb, started to run towards the forest. That's why Sukha Goswami Pad, in front of Sonakadi Rishi, they are saying this. Haribo, so the battery in the live phone is very less, so the audio will be recorded for further Harikatha. The phone may die anytime. One who have not done any sanskar. No pavitra sanskar, no receiving sacred thread, no even name was given. Sadhu went towards the forest. And behind him, Vyasadev started to say, Ha putra, and started to run. Vyasadev sound started to came. He said, oh, my dear son, and the trees, mountains, the sound echoed.
What
the mountains were echoing. Whose child? Who is your child? Who is father? If body dies, the relationship also ends.
शरीर पलट जाए बदल जाए तो कभी किसी के कोई